1484, Setenil, Emirate of Granada. As the Reconquista of the Iberian Peninsula from the Islamic Moors continues, Spain finds its efforts revitalized by its zealous Catholic monarchs, King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella. King Ferdinand, leading the Spanish efforts on the field, is renowned as a skilled warrior with a passion for artillery. The Spanish king now seeks to remove yet another Moorish fortress, keeping to his policy of leaving no enemies behind him as he moves towards the Moors' capital. With a new train of artillery provided by his wife, Queen Isabella, King Ferdinand builds a small artillery emplacement outside Setenil's walls and prepares to lay waste to the defenses. Built on a giant rock, with the only access a ramp carved from stone leading up to the fortress, Setenil will be as impenetrable as the stone on which it is built. The king, confident in his cannons, builds no siege equipment, believing he can destroy the walls at range and hasten the Moors' demise. The Moors stand prepared, with ample crossbowmen and artillery positioned behind the protective walls, ready to bleed the Spaniards dry unless they can quickly drive through these walls. For the Reconquista to proceed, Setenil must be captured. A hard land breeds a hard people. Today, the Spanish must be the harder.
Victory! must fall. It is time to charge men through to slay our ungodly foe. For glory and victory!
Thank you.
Only intervention by the Almighty Lord or a military genius can bring us victory from this disgrace. Praise to God, we have captured the enemy's walls. gates are down! To charge men through to slay our ungodly foe. the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain. Seems to be swinging in our favor. From such tidings does victory emerge.
Thank you.
Our men have slain the Saracen general. Now we must send his men running back to the desert. Lord above, our foe has been much humbled. Let all who remember this day remember it as the day of our most glorious victory.